United Kingdom's economy shrinks by 1.5%, mass shootings, and the Congressional Oversight Panel says that this financial crisis is far from over. Hello, it's April 8th, 2009. I'm Dimcat, also known as Reginald. First, I want to talk about all these mass shootings. It's going to be really short. A man killed his wife and three others just hours after a divorce case. He shot his 11-year-old daughter and two relatives. The wife claimed that he was physically and emotionally abusive. Kevin Garner was 45 years old, and he accused his wife of cheating on him and taking out $38,000 out of their joint bank account after they separated. Another man, James Harrison, 34 years old, he killed his wife and five children. Okay, the ages range from 7 to 16. What the hell is wrong with people? I don't understand why people are losing it. Well, I mean, I do, but I'm not sure it's all related to the economy, but I mean, a lot of people are just losing it. But I do believe that the administration is going to do something about it. I think this is going to be an excellent opportunity for gun control people to say that we got to start grabbing guns, we got to start restricting guns, because pretty much always happens whenever there's a bunch of shootings. The guns aren't the problem. The individuals are the problem. Small retailers are looking for more creative ways to increase revenue. Some are offering terror reading. Yeah, terror readings. Some are offering hot dogs and other food. Others are offering blood pressure screenings. And wow, yeah, it's pretty interesting, because one store owner is actually throwing cocktail parties and book signings, and she started a rewards program where if you spend $500, you get 20% off on your next purchase. According to the Congressional Oversight Panel, the crisis is not over. The financial crisis is far from over. Yeah, well, that's pretty obvious to me and anybody who's really watching. Group that was really supposed to be overlooking or overseeing TARP, the Troubled Assets Relief Program, is basically criticizing the Treasury Department for its lack of transparency. They're basically saying they're probably going to spend they're spending trillions of dollars on this mess. We're learning a lot more about the UK. The gross domestic product in the UK dropped 1.5%. This is the fastest pace in decades. Consumer confidence is shrinking. How do you guys think this crisis is going to play out? How do you see this crisis playing out? Do you think we're going to go into a world recession, a world depression? I think it is a world recession. Do you think that Europe is going to do worse than the United States, or vice versa? I would like to see what people think about that. So leave a comment. Here's what I think is going to happen. I think Europe is going to have a 2 to 3 year deep recession. I think so will Japan. I think China and India is going to have a 1 to 2 year recession. I think the U.S. is going to have a 5 to 7 year depression. That's one of the scenarios I see. Last time we entered a depression, we at least had some type of manufacturing capacity. That's no longer the case. Okay, yes, I'm still practicing with my gun, and I went out to the range, so here's an update.
Yeah, this is where I came the first time. Got my headphones on. Got little earplugs in there. Probably sound really funny right now.
Here's the question of the day. How much money do you think the federal government is going to end up spending by the time this crisis is over?